saying anything that goes against the word of God, you say, I respectfully disagree with you, and you are telling me a lie, so I don't believe you. And sometimes you don't actually say it to their face. Hey, sometimes you need to. I'll go ahead and tell you, sometimes you're going through something, your marriage is getting kind of rocky. Hey, the first 5 years of my marriage were hell. I don't know how we didn't kill each other. I actually tried to kill him once. He told me if I didn't knock it off, he was going to call the police. True story. I was a little, wasn't always the mighty woman of God I am today. Back then, I had several people, my own father included, that said, baby, if you want to divorce him, I'll come get you. Pretty sure he had people say, that woman is nuts. You need to get away from her. You need to divorce her. Guess what? Guess what we did? We didn't stay married because we really loved each other. We didn't stay married because we liked each other. We stood married because we stood firm and agreed with the word of God that no matter what you may covet. Guess what? The covenant of marriage is absolutely what God put together. No man will tear apart. I don't care if you're my mama or my daddy. If you tell me I should get a divorce, I'm sorry. I love you. I'm honoring you like the Bible says, but I will not divorce this man because God said that we are to stay married because we're in covenant. And if covenant's what it takes, covenant's what it takes. The love will come back later. Guess what? For about 3 years, I didn't love that man. And I'm not saying anything he doesn't already know. Somebody in here is thinking, oh my gosh, she's talking about her husband like that. Guess what? He'll tell you the same thing. It took about 3 years for that love and feeling to come back. I don't even know that song. I think it's stupid. Guess what? I love him more today than I did when I said I do. There's no man on this planet that is more handsome or can do anything, provide for me, encourage me, tell me what the Word of God says more than my husband. Why? Because I stood on covenant. Because I came in agreement with the word. I learned the truth and then I stood in covenant with it. The next thing we have to do, after we learn how to stand firm and come in agreement, the next thing, this is where it gets hard. The next thing we have to do is actually do what the word says. This is when we have to actually obey. James 1:22 says, but be doers of the word, not hearers only, deceiving yourselves. For if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, he is like a man who looks at himself. He looks intently at his natural face in a mirror for 24 hours, and when he walks away, he forgets what he looks like. I don't think I could look in a mirror that long. What James is saying is, you got to put some action to it. You got to get your feet moving. You recognize the truth. You get in the Word and you find out what it says and you find out what the truth is, and then you come in agreement with it. You stand firm with it. You say, no matter what, you're not moving me. This is what the Word of God says. There's two things that the Word of God says that I can tell you right now, absolutely, you're not moving me. I don't care what you say. I don't care how many degrees you got. I don't care what you tell me. One, that I am a child of God. I accepted the free gift of salvation. There ain't nothing you can do to tell me otherwise. I am His daughter. I've had people try to tell me I wasn't. You are not telling the truth. And that God heals. He is in the healing business. You cannot talk me out of that. But the word says that we have to do something for him to heal. The word says that Jesus, that the Holy Spirit has given us power and authority. Well, Jesus ain't walking around on earth anymore. Did you notice that? He came. came. He did what the Father sent him to do. He died on the cross. He rose again. And then he ascended to the Father because he's getting things ready to come back and get us. And he said, okay, now I'm giving you all power and authority to heal the sick, raise the dead, and preach the gospel.
That's right.
That means that I got something I got to do. That means that I actually have to put some feet to it. And when Jillian tells me she's got a headache, all I have to do is go, headache, be gone in Jesus' name. And it has to leave. But if I don't do something, it's never going to happen. I also asked Miss Laura this morning if she would pray for my throat. If she would have just went, huh. She actually had to do something. Words had to actually come out of her mouth. She already knew, because I know that she already knows what the truth says. I already know she's in agreement with the truth. If I wouldn't have known those first two things, I wouldn't have asked her in the first place. And I knew that she would obey the word. Not me, the word. If somebody comes and asks you to pray for them, why wouldn't you? Unless you're trying to stir their faith up and get them to ask you answer a few questions, like Shane was with me this morning. He was going to pray for me. All he wanted me to do was to acknowledge the truth and come in agreement with it. And then he would obey the word and pray for me. Obey it. Puts actions to our word. Old saying, and push your money where your mouth is, that's what it does. Because action is going to produce change and fruit. See, we get to have fruit of the Spirit. And when we come in agreement with the truth, and we stand firm in it, and then we start doing what it says, all of a sudden we start producing fruit. Look at here, I got some patience over here. Let me grab that stuff here. Let me eat it. Patience is a fruit of the Spirit. Long suffering is a fruit of the Spirit. Let me grab that thing. Now, if I'm not doing what the Word tells me to do, I'm not going to want long suffering. There's some fruits that I'll be like, yeah, let me have all that one I can get. Long suffering? No, thank you. I don't think I want that one. And there's a secret. There's a secret to obeying. See these teenagers? They hear what we say. They have these things called ears on the side of their head. They actually hear the words that are coming out of our mouth. Most of the time it sounds like this. Wah, 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 wah. It's like Charlie Brown. They do what they see us do. So when we look at the Word and the Word says to honor all authority, because all authority has been placed there by God, when they see me honoring Shane, they're going to honor. Now if they hear me say honor all authority and they turn around and I'm cussing him out, guess what they're going to do? My name is Cody Jessman, and I just saw Pastor Amanda cuss out her husband, so I'm going to come over here and cuss out my mama. Because, yeah, she told me not to do it, but she turned around and did it. So it must be okay, because she put action to it. When they see me call President Obama, President Obama, not Mr. or not by his first name, but President, because I don't care if you agree with him or not, I don't care if he's a good man or a bad man, I don't care. God said honor all authority, because he placed him there. That man has a title.
Yeah.
And I will call him by that title, because my God said to honor the Lord.
Yeah.
If I want my students, if I want the generation coming up after me to do what I say, then I better do what I say. Because they're going to do what they see me do. They ain't going to do what they hear me say. You've been a parent for 5 minutes. You figure that out. And the last thing that we do is train up the next generation. I love this scripture. Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. How do we train them up? It's so easy. Did you know that Jesus did it? He modeled it for us. He took 12 men. He said, y'all come here. He went and grabbed these 12 men up. He said, y'all come here. He said, I want you to watch me. I want you to follow me. And I want you to watch me. I want you to watch me teach you how to recognize the truth. I want you to watch me teach you how to come in agreement with the word. And back then, I don't think he had it. He was the word, so he just told him. Then he said, I want you to watch me do it. I want you to watch me heal the sick. I want you to watch me raise Lazarus from the dead. I want you to watch me. I want you to watch me. And then, when you get it, then I want you to do this over here. Come here, Gabby. Then I want you to go here. Open this. You see that truth right there? Okay, let's go study that truth for a little while. That's a good truth, isn't it? You got it? Do you think you can recognize when somebody comes and tells you something that's different than that truth right there? Okay, so now we recognize the truth. Do you agree with what that says? Okay. So to honor authority, that means that we can't be back talking. We can't be rolling our eyes. None of that, right? So we agree that God said that we have to honor all authority, whether we agree with them or not, whether they're nice or whether they're not nice, right? Okay. So now we're going to obey the word, right? Okay. Are you sure you got that truth, right? Get it? Okay. Now this is what I want you to do, baby. I want you to go over there to Kingdom Kids, and I want you to go find a fifth grader, and I want you to teach them the same thing, okay? That's what training up the next generation looks like. It's, I've gotten in the truth, and I can recognize a lie now. I don't have it all right. I'm not a Bible scholar. I don't have 50 million PhDs behind my name, but there's a truth in the Word of God that I got. I got that thing. Okay, I got it. Now, I'm in agreement with it. And it says I got to do something, so I might as well start learning it all. And now that I got it, I got a few. Now I'm going to go grab me a teenager, and I'm going to say, look at this. Look at this. Let's start to learn and recognize the truth together and agree with it and do what it says. And then when they get a truth and they go, wow, I don't have it all together either, but I got this one. I got these few little nuggets of truth right here, and I agree with every single one of them, and I'm doing the best I can to do what this word says. Okay, now I'm going to go get the next generation, and I'm going to teach them to do the same thing. And it just never ends. And we train up, and we train up, and we train up. Because if we don't stand for something, they will fall for anything. Now, we recognize the truth. We stand firm. We come in agreement. We obey, and we train up. Okay? What happens if we don't? What happens if we don't? What happens if we go, you know what? I don't like to read. I don't want to read. Reading's boring. Bible's boring. I don't want to read it. So I'm not going to. So I don't read it. I don't come in agreement with it. I don't do what it says. And I surely don't train up the next generation. What's going to happen if we don't do it? Let me paint you a picture of what's going to happen. My name is Fred, and I'm 16. And nobody has stood for anything in my life. Nobody's taught me any truth. So I was on the internet the other night looking at porn. And as I was doing that, this little screen popped up. And it said, if you want a family, if you want somebody to love you, come join our group. So I said, you know what? I'm tired of all these people in Plainfield County High School telling me they like me and they don't. They talk trash about me. My parents don't like me. They go to church on Sunday and go to the club on Monday. They be getting stoned on Thursday. whatever. So yeah, I'm gonna join this group. So I'm with this group for about 6 months, and all of a sudden, they say, hey, could you go pick up this backpack for me? And could you go to the Eastman Movie Theater on Friday, about 9 o'clock, at the biggest showing? And could you walk in there? That's all you gotta do, just walk in there. And they do it, they put a back on, they get the backpack, and they walk in there at 9 o'clock, right in the middle, concession stand and popcorn. And when they do, that's it. Boom. They take themselves, a couple dozen or a couple hundred people with them. And then them and probably about half of the people in there with them, now, then in the blink of an eye, all of a sudden they're going, where am I? And now they are eternally separated from God. What happens if we don't do these things? That's what happens. The bomb isn't the big thing. What the big thing is, now they're eternally separated from God. Now they're in hell. If we adults do not rise up and stand for something, they're going to fall for anything. And what they're going to fall for is a lifetime, an eternity in hell. How important is it to recognize the truth, stand firm in the truth, and obey the truth, and raise up the next generation? It's life altering. Y'all didn't hear me. It's life altering. Guess what? Cody Justin just graduated high school last year. Stand up, baby. We just today said, okay, Cody, you have graduated. You are in a new season of becoming a grown man. His mama's going, he ain't grown yet. Guess what? I'm his youth pastor. He's been with me for a while. I'm going to go, you ain't grown yet either. But he is a man of God now. But guess what? Because he's had some mighty men and women of God in his life that said, Cody, I'm going to stand for something, son. You're going to watch me walk this thing out. You're going to watch me have an argument with my husband and get it wrong and say things I shouldn't. But then you're going to watch me go back and say, I love you. Forgive me. You're going to watch that man get mad at a lawnmower. But then you're going to watch him teach you how to go back and redo that. That way, when the enemy comes against him and says, son, you're a good-looking man. You need to go sow your wild oats with every girl in town. Cody will go, I don't think so. The Word of God says that you should not have sex before marriage, and I am special. There's only one of me, and honey, you ain't getting it till I put a ring on it. Mama and John standing for something so he wouldn't fall for anything, if he didn't have Shane to start out as his youth pastor and me to come up behind him and say, we're going to stand for something so you don't fall for anything, then when that pretty girl came by, guess what had happened? Whoop, there goes his riches. It's true. And then all of a sudden, every dream, every aspiration, every dream he had of going anywhere, because now he doesn't even have, now when he looks at himself in the mirror, he goes, I'm so dirty. I'm so nasty. Hey, I know girls think it, and I know young men think it too. Because if we don't stand for something, they're going to fall for anything. Guys, thank you so much. Thank you so much. Let's get ready to do our communication call.
Blessed today.
Yes.
It's been a good day.
Yeah.
We end the service with our communication cards. We ask that everybody in the house fill this card out. Would you do that for me as a personal favor? Fill out the card. There's some questions on there. We'd like to know what you thought about today. What's it like? What can we do better? And how can we serve you even better? So fill that out. If you're a visitor, welcome. We're pretty much always about like this. So I hope you were ministered to by the music, the drama. It's just been an amazing day. What a privilege to be with you guys. As you're filling those out, ushers, y'all go grab those baskets wherever they are. Somebody help me out with that. And let's have some. We'll take them up. You want to say something? That's yours.
I'm the amendment lady today. Please, if you would, please put your name on the communication card up to the left or right side, okay? That way we know specifically who we're praying for also, okay?
Yeah, want to know your name. All right, so we're getting the baskets for that. We're going to praise our way out of here in just a second. Don't forget, this Wednesday night, we'll have a service for the youth, the children, and the adults. We start at 7 o'clock sharp. We'll try to get out right at 8-ish, because we know a lot of folks have to get home and get to bed and get to work, and you're probably getting the kids on a school schedule this week. That's a tongue twister. Amen. I'm waiting on my baskets. Here they come. Thank you, Michael. All right, so if you will, just fill those in. Just to remind you, you can always give to the church online at houseofgrace.com. I'm saying it wrong now. Houseofgrace.church. And we're working on a new website, a new church app, all kind of good things in the mix. And we've got some news coming soon on our Hawkinsville campus. We've been talking Hawkinsville for about 18 months. And we've got some good news right around the corner. Would you pray for that? Because we believe that Hawkinsville, God has big plans for Hawkinsville that include House of Grace. Amen? Amen. Well, let's roll some music and we'll take up these cards. Love each other and love the lost this week. God bless you.